Samantha Spinner and the super secret plans. Samantha Spinner and the super secret plans. Going to Egypt, going to France, looking for the man in the green plaid pants. Sam Spinner and the super secret plans.
Samantha Spinner and the boy in the ball.
See the apartment glisten, your brother still won't listen. In this adventure, he's the one who went and wound up missing.
The marble coaster's roaring, your sister thinks you're boring. You made some friends to take along with you when you're exploring.
You better watch out, cause your next door neighbor is the worst. She stole the New York Yankees even though they might be cursed. If you don't make it to Seattle, you could die of thirst. I hope that deadly ninja monkey doesn't find you first.
Listening Library presents Samantha Spinner and the Boy in the Ball by Russell Ginns. Read for you by Kathleen McInerney with Grover Gardner. And including bonus audio puzzles created and presented by the author at the end of this audiobook.
The Gateway Arch. In St. Louis, Missouri, the Gateway Arch curves proudly beside the Mississippi River. At 630 feet, it is the world's tallest arch, the tallest monument built by humans in North America, and, of course, the tallest structure in the city. Completed in 1965 as a monument to westward expansion in the United States, the arch is an instantly recognizable symbol of St. Louis and a major tourist attraction. The observation deck provides an excellent view of the surrounding city and far beyond. The Corn Palace. The Corn Palace in Mitchell, South Dakota, is a public arena. Hockey games, concerts, and conventions take place inside, surrounded by corn. The outside of the building is covered with real corn cobs and corn husks. Local artists use them to create colorful murals. Updated almost every year, the corn creations showcase farming, music, sports, geography, and highlights of American history and culture.
Both of these landmarks are located above entrances to the Hover Disk Highway. Standing on a disc that floats on a cushion of air, you can zoom through the highway's underground tunnels like a puck gliding on an air hockey table. Successful hover disc operation requires a combination of balance, quick reflexes, and precise computation. Depending on your skill, you can cruise under the Great Plains at speeds of up to 300 miles per hour. Of course, it's very important to pay attention to low clearance warnings. Watch out for the head, horizontally extending architectural dangers. Chapter 1. The Bad Seed.
Bird brain! Bird brain!
Missy Snodgrass's parrot was still squawking. It never stopped.
Wait a minute! Wait a minute!
Nipper had been awake the entire night. Every time he closed his eyes, the horrible bird started talking or squawking or shrieking again.
Let's roll! Let's roll!
And, of course, it's hard to fall asleep inside a big ball of yarn. Everything had happened so fast. One moment, he was standing in his living room talking to Missy. The next moment, she was rolling him head over heels up the Snodgrass driveway in a massive yarn ball.
Pajama Paul! Pajama Paul!
After finally finding Uncle Paul with his sister Samantha, Nipper had had to rush home from New York. His dad had signed him up for calculus camp, Camp Pythagoras. It was an unbreakable contract, and if he didn't show up on time, there would be trouble. Nipper wasn't looking forward to 5 weeks of calculator karaoke, algebra art projects, and long division dancing. The trigonometry time trials sounded just awful. But getting trapped in a ball of yarn where you couldn't move your arms or legs was even worse. He couldn't see anything but yellow wool, and it was really itchy.
Yankees lose! Yankees lose!
Nipper was tired, sore, and hungry. And worst of all, his Yankees really needed him. While she wrapped him up in yarn, Missy had swiped all the New York Yankees player contracts again. She had snatched the deed to Yankee Stadium again. Somewhere out there, beyond the yarn, his Yankees were on a 100-game losing streak, and he was too tied up to do anything to save them.
Watch out for the... Watch out for the... Watch out for the...
Jeremy Bernard Spinner, called a voice. Stop bothering my bird. You're going to wear her out.
Through a gap in the yarn, Nipper could see the yellow polka dot blouse Missy Snodgrass always wore.
Come on, Missy, he pleaded. I've been stuck in here all night. I feel like my head's about to explode.
Thanks for your words of encouragement, she replied. I'm trying to set the record for the world's biggest ball of yarn, or string, or twine.
Those are three different records, said Nipper.
Through a gap, he saw her shadow circling. He figured she was still adding to the ball.
And you're not even close, he told her. All three records are more than 10 feet in diameter.
I know, said Missy. And I'd probably get disqualified anyway, because there would be a dead boy inside.
Nipper gulped. He didn't want to find out if Missy was joking, or if she really meant it about the dead boy. There had to be a way to escape. He shifted his weight and rocked the ball back and forth a little.
Stop that, said Missy.
Nipper felt her grab the ball to hold it still. He spotted some fingers through the yarn. On one of them, she wore the emerald scorpion ring he had given her months ago. The green gem flashed.
Tell you what, she said. I'll let you go if you give me something I want.
You already have my baseball team, said Nipper. Nothing's more precious than that.
Well, your uncle is always giving away interesting presents to you and your sisters, she said.
I've got 2 toy cars and some stickers,
Nipper replied, eager to make a deal.
I also have a weird spoon, an old silver dollar, and a really fancy pocket watch.
He struggled to twist his body as he spoke, but the yarn held him in place.
Let me go, and you can have all of it, he pleaded.
Missy's shadow disappeared and reappeared. He hoped she was walking around him, considering his offer. Polka dot fabric appeared again, very close to him now.
I'm not interested in stickers, spoons, or watches, said Missy. But what about that umbrella your sister drags around? I'd like to get my hands on that.
Samantha's not here, said Nipper. She's still in New York City, and she's with...
He stopped himself. He was pretty sure Sam wouldn't want him to discuss their adventures, especially with someone who was double, triple, super evil.
She'll be back in a few days, he said.
Fine, said Missy. I can wait. I'm a very patient person. When your sister comes back, I'll let you go.
When she comes back? Nipper cried. I said a few days.
A strand of yellow dropped in front of his left eye. It reminded him of mustard. That reminded him of hot dogs.
And I'm getting hungry, he whined.
Hungry?
she asked.
I can help you with that.
Through the yarn, Nipper could see her reaching into the front pocket of her blouse. She pulled out her hand, reached up to the ball, and slapped the gap in the yarn near his mouth. Little round, dry bits came flying in. He licked his lips. Crunchy, but not much flavor. Seeds?
Hey, he shouted, spitting them out. This is bird food. Oh, so now you're a picky eater?
Asked Missy.
Picky eater, picky eater, picky eater,
squawked the parrot. In the distance, a doorbell rang. Missy leaned in close.
You're going no place, she whispered through the yarn.
Nipper heard her walk up the side porch and into her house. He really needed to get out of there. He shifted his weight and tried to make the ball rock again.
No place, no place,
screeched the horrible bird. Chapter 2. By George. George Spinner stood on the Snodgrass front porch.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.